हरि ओम नमः सर्वेभ्यः। अद्य भाषा प्रवेश प्रथम भागस्य एकत्रिंशत्तमी कक्षार्थं भवतां सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। इन अर्लियर वी हैव सीन समथिंग इज प्रिफिक्स्ड विद द धातु एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज उपसर्ग और उपसर्गतुल्य, राइट? हाँ, लेट अस सी सम व्हाट आर द अदर्स, लाइक व्हाट आर दोस उपसर्गतुल्यस। Okay, so upasargas, we have fixed number of upasargas. They are 22. Only these can get us attached. And upasarga tulyas, they are literally infinite. Okay, there is no count. It can go, it goes infinitely. There is no definite count for that. Oh, but we can actually see some examples. Example is alam, bahis, and antar. Okay, but these are all not upasargas, but they are equivalent to upasargas. So when I say equivalent to upasargas, whatever upasarga rules we apply, all those rules we need to even apply for these words as well. So the primary rule which we learned so far is upasargas will always get prefixed with a dhatu. So that means these words will also get prefixed with the dhatu. So alam, bahis, and antar. For example, alam plus karoti, alam karoti to decorate. Okay, basically alam means it gives a meaning of enough, or paryaptam, that's the meaning of alam. But alam plus karoti, alam karoti, it gives a meaning of decorating. And bahis plus karoti, bahish karoti, eject, that's a meaning of, it's a meaning of eject actually. Bahish karoti, making somebody out. And similarly, antar plus bhavati, antar bhavati, meaning it is embedded or involved in certain thing. That's called as antar bhavati. So it is inside. That's what it means. Okay, so similarly, you may also come across a few different upasarga tulyas going forward. But this is just example for upasarga tulyas. So not only this, we also have another set of words which they are also considered as upasarga tulyas. Example, svi and ushni and sajji and so on. Okay, example, svi karoti. Karoti is to do, and svi karoti is to take or accept. Okay, and svi is not a upasarga, it is upasarga tulya because it's not in the list of 22. And again, ushni karoti. So ushni karoti, ushna is the heat, and ushni karoti means heating. Heating is actually called as ushni karoti. That's a verb form. And sajji karoti, getting ready. Okay, so sajji karoti, ushni karoti, svi karoti, and so on. So basically bottom two sections, they are the upasarga tulyas, and we don't have a definite count. Okay, and we just need to learn on the go. But first set, the 22, we have a definite count, and we can also get meanings from dictionary. Okay, that's about this one. Okay, now let us move on to the next one. Okay, next one is there are certain rules or maybe certain things to know about upasargas. Okay, maybe the ground rules or maybe certain things we need to remember on upasargas. One is upasargaha dhatoho purvam bhavati. The upasarga always come before dhatu. So you cannot attach it after the dhatu. It always comes before. Avayara, anu, anugachati, agachati, all of them before the dhatu. Example, a plus gachati, agachati. And similarly, kadachit dhatoho purvam Dvitraha upasargaha bhavanti. So not necessarily you have only one upasarga and you have only 22 different forms of a verb. Definitely no. You will have sometimes two upasargas, sometimes three upasargas, or sometimes even four upasargas you might see before dhatu. The example is prati plus a plus gachati, pratyagachati. Okay, and another example is samudaharati. If you take samudaharati, sam plus ud plus a plus harati, samuda harati. So giving some examples, that's what it means. So these are examples where you get more than 1, 2, or 3 upasargas. And a few other rules, okay. So what happens when we attach a upasarga to a dhatu? Okay, so primary thing what happens, okay, this is the above one is how to attach and where to attach. And now we are seeing, going to see what is the effect of attaching that upasargas. So when you attach a upasarga, there are two things can happen. One is the meaning of the dhatu can change. Okay, either it can change the meaning, that means it can affect the meaning of the dhatu, or sometimes the upasargas will not even do anything with the dhatu. It just comes as a placeholder, but it will not even have any meaning. So it will not do any change with the dhatu, just stays. The second thing is it can affect the meaning. Okay, it can change the meaning in a way that it can enhance the meaning, or it can even give the completely different meaning. Okay, and the third category is it can also change the certain properties of the dhatu. Okay, so we are going to see examples for all of these, and we'll understand what are they. The first is very simple. There is certain upasargas will not even make any much difference with the dhatu, just stays as a placeholder. Example is vasati and nivasati, and in such cases it gives almost the same meaning. Okay, those there are subtle difference, but it doesn't even make big difference. Okay, vasati and nivasati both means the same, to reside or to live. And second category where it actually changes the meaning of the dhatu in a way that it can actually enhance the meaning, or it can even give completely different meaning than the original dhatu. The example kadachit upasargaha dhatoho artham parivartate. Okay, sometimes the meaning of the dhatu can be changed. Example, v plus smarati, smarati and vismarati. So smarati is to remember and vismarati to forget. It gives completely opposite meaning. And sometimes kadachit upasargaha dhatoho arthasya poshanam karoti. Sometimes it actually enhances the meaning of the dhatu. Basically, it actually insists enhances the meaning of the dhatu. Example, likhati and vilikhati. So, likhati is also writing, and vilikhati is also to write, but vilikhati is to enhance the writing. So, mostly we, for the rishis or kavis, we generally will say vilikhati rather than likhati. So, balakaha likhati and kalidasaha vilikhati. Okay, just to enhance that is writing. Okay, that's the way. It just gives an enhanced meaning of the same likhati. So, other category is where the upasargas can actually change or alter certain properties of the dhatu. So, now when it comes to properties, what are those properties? Okay, there are various properties by which the meaning of the dhatu or the forms of the dhatu can change. But let us not get into that for now. One of such properties is the pada. Each dhatu has some pada property associated, which decides the form of the verb form. Okay, verb form. Basically, if you see the example of pat, the forms are like patati, patataha, patanti. It goes in certain pattern. Okay, and similarly, there are again other set of dhatus which will produce the same latlakara forms in different form, like example vardate or kampate. So these, if you see the ending letters are te, not ti. Okay, so patati, vardati, likhati, it all ends with ti, but certain dhatus they end with te, like vandate, vardate, kampate, and all svardate, and all these are actually examples for te endings. Okay, but how it is decided? But both have dhatus, but there is a property called pada of the dhatu that decides whether it will end with ti or it will end with te. But let us not get into that. We have a separate chapter in Bhasha Pravesha level 2. We'll study at that time. But for now, Pada is one such character, property which decides whether the verb form will end with the or te. So sometimes when you associate, when you attach a upasarga to a dhatu, it can also change the ending of the verb form. Okay, let's see the example. So kadachit parasmepadi dhatu atmanepadi bhavati, patmanepadi dhatu parasmepadi tvamapi bhavati. The example, jayati. Jayati is a pars. Okay, the when I say pada, it has primarily it has two padas, parasmai padam and atmane padam. Whatever endings we see with the endings, they are all actually parasmai pada dhatus. Patati, likati, vadati, and all are actually parasmai padam. And atmane padam means whichever is ending with te, like vandate, vardhate, svardhate, and all of them actually they are atmane pada dhatus. Okay, so when you associate the upasargas, certain upasargas with certain dhatus, the pada gets changed. So jayati is a parasmaipadi dhatu because it ends with ti. So when you add v plus jayati, it becomes vijayate. Vijayati is the wrong usage, it becomes vijayate. Okay, it's again, it becomes atmanepadi dhatu. So v just jayati is a parasmaipadi prayoga. And vijayate, it becomes atmanepadi prayoga. You cannot use it as vijayati. That is completely wrong. And similarly, other example is ramate. Okay, ramate to enjoy, and viramate, when you associate v with that, the ramate is atmanepadi dhatu, atmanepadi verb form, and it becomes viramati. It becomes parasmepadi. See, this is so jayati vijayate is the example for parasmapadi to atmanepadi, and ramati and viramati is the example for atmanepadi to parasmapadi. So basically all we need to know is upasargas can also change the properties of the dhatu like parasmapadi and atmanepadi. So that's the takeaway from this slide actually. So here I have a very short exercise. Find any two verb roots of your choice, and for each one of them, you try to find, you try to provide examples in below categories where arthasya poshanam. So you take any two dhatus and provide two different upasarga combinations where one gives arthasya poshanam and other gives arthasya parivartanam. So arthasya parivartanam smarati and vismarati, and arthasya poshanam vishati and pravishati. So that's a vishati is just enter, pravishati is to again enter, but it enhances the meaning. So you try to find two verbs forms and find two examples for these categories, arthasya poshanam and arthasya parivartanam. That's exercise for this section. As long as you are able to remember these rules, five ground rules, like it can come before the dhatu, and sometimes more than one upasarga can come along with the dhatu, and the upasargas can change the meaning or it can actually enhance the meaning, and it can also change the pada of the dhatu, like a parasmaipaditu atmanepadi and atmanepaditu parasmaipadi. If you are knowing these things, and there are 22 upasargas, and there are again upasarga tulyas which also behaves the same way, and that should be enough. That's a takeaway from this lesson actually.
Mahodaya, parinayati, yeah. Is it meaning marry? Because I have read Ramaha Sitam parinayati.
Parinayati.
Nakaram asya.
Yeah, parinayati
okay, but is the same nayati changes to nayati?
Yes, and that's basically the Natva rule, Parinayati.
Okay. So Parinayati is to marry.
Yeah, is to marry, yes.
And Pranayati is also there. Pranayati, which is composing. Valmiki Praramayanam Pranayati.
Yes.
Okay, Dhanyavada.
This Arthasya Parivartanam itself is the, that Parivartanam itself is the Upasarga, right?
Yes.
And that parivartanam means actually Vartanam is the meaning I have seen turn. Is it the different meaning, Vartanam and Parivartanam?
No, Vartanam is to exist and Parivartanam is to change.
Parivartanam is the change. But Vartanam, what is the meaning? Sorry? Vartanam
is? Vartanam is just existing. Just existing. Asti, that's the meaning of Vartanam. Yeah.
That is the opposite.
You may even see some other example. Yes.
When I'm using this dictionary, I get totally different screen to what you are getting, but I'm actually using the English, like you were trying me in Sanskrit, and you got different usage, but I got totally different screens, you know. So
okay, what did you type actually here for me?
N-I.
See, you need to check this, especially this particular format. Okay, so if you're typing any Sanskrit word in English, just check this format. For example, N-I means small I, and ni, right, is a capital I here. Small N and capital I. I think now you'll get that knee here. You get that all. Okay, yeah. Thank you. And coming back to your first question, the shloka meanings of the starting prayer and ending prayers, I would suggest wait till the end of this session. You will get to know with your own knowledge. Because most of the words are actually the regular simple words. You will be able to re-understand that shloka maybe sooner in due course in the Bhasha Pravesha Bhaga 1 itself. Even by now, I think you would have already understood the meaning of the ending prayer, but starting prayer would take some time to understand. We'll do it as part of the session itself. Yeah. Okay, so with that, we will... okay. Okay, there are questions on the chat. Will it be possible to post the exercises on course forum page? Yes, this will be posted on the forum page, and I will also update the course page also. Okay, I'll do it in this weekend. Okay. So with that, we'll end the session. Sankshepa is simple. We have completed the book exercises of Yada and Tada. And we have seen what are upasargas, and primary five rules, like upasargas always come as a prefixes, and more than one upasargas can come before the dhatu, and it can sometimes enhance the meaning, or sometimes it can just change completely the meaning, or sometimes the pada of the dhatu can be altered, or sometimes it will not even do anything, just stays as a placeholder. And this is upasarga, and we have few more things to know about the upasargas. We will learn it maybe in the subsequent sessions. But for now, the meanings of the upasargas you can get only through the dictionaries. Okay, same as any other verb or noun, you need to look up into the dictionary and find the meanings. Yeah, that's all for today. Thank you for watching this video online. If there are any questions or if you want to interact with the teachers or students, log into forum.sanskrit.today, or you can even join the Telegram group. The link is at the course page. And subscribe to this channel, Sanskrit.today, to watch more videos like this, and share this video with your friends and fam, friends and interested people or group. And make use of the comment section below the video if you have any feedback or suggestions about this video or the series. And finally, click on the like button, and thank you all for watching this video. And let us meet in the next session with some other topic. Dhanyavadaha.